Hi everybody, I hope you're doing well. My interests are all over the map, and so is this YouTube channel. Then there was the time that I wanted to check out every food festival within reasonable driving distance. One year I wanted to bike every bike path, another kayak every river nearby. In particular, the ones I could just pull up to the side of the road and throw the kayak in the water. Then COVID hit, and it was all about hoarding food and hiding behind the sofa. So I'm thinking my next series of videos is going to be about...
Dun dun dun!
Spam comes in a lot of flavors, and I've decided that my New Year's resolution is to try every one. I recently made a video where I recreated the McDonald's sandwich that's in China. Spam and Oreo cookie. People were so horrified by that. Yeah, I'm gonna do some more cooking. Today I'm just gonna walk through the flavors I have and tell you what I think about them. Now, I grew up with the traditional Spam and I love it. You can eat this straight out of the can, but it's kind of soft. What you want to do is cut in slices, throw it in a frying pan, and toast it up. So it's a little bit crunchy on the outside, a little bit soft on the inside. You got something awesome. It's a nice alternative to bacon. And Spam will last decades. This is a great thing to have in the back of a cabinet, you know, in case there's an ice storm or a pandemic. Nah, that can never happen. Now, lately, I've been, watching my weight and my cholesterol and my salt intake, so I've been eating more of this when I do have Spam. Also, there's like 6 portions in a can, and instead of eating the whole can, I'll have just 1 portion. Now, the one which will catch your attention, probably the fastest of all these, is bacon. And it's Spam with some bacon flavor mixed in, and it's nice. But honestly, the hickory smoke, I think, tastes more like bacon than the bacon one does. So this is my number 2 favorite, I think, you know? And honestly, if I put them side to side, there are days I probably pick this as number 1. So far, original Spam and hickory smoke. If you've never had this before, one of these two would be the best to try. Now, you see turkey. Turkey's good. It's a little bland. This is the sort of thing I think it's probably best to probably cook with. And I'll have some videos showing that, like cutting up in little cubes the size of a pea, toasting them up, and mixing them into scrambled eggs or something like that. Hot and spicy. This one's interesting. It is spicy. Personally, I think original Spam with maybe some Tabasco sauce might be actually better than this for a couple reasons. One, there's not a whole lot of, say, Tabasco or buffalo flavor in this. It's really the heat, which kind of bites you after the fact, which is fine because it's a fine taste. But you know, when I'm cooking it and frying it up, that pepper, when you fry with pepper, just turns into like a poison gas and everybody's coughing and gagging. Now, here are the two in my collection that I've recently got that I've never tried, and I'll do another video where I'm taste testing these and some more I have coming. This one's tocino. This is a Filipino spice. And this is garlic. Now, a little disappointed in this purchase. Years back, Monty Python did a stage play called Spamalot. Had nothing to do with Hormel, but Hormel went, wow, people are really liking the stage show, let's get in on the act. So they came out with a special edition flavor called something like French stinking garlic spam. And they had crazy, you know, images on it, which were a salute to this Monty Python stage play. But no, it's just kind of the standard garlic spam.